I really emerged into, I stopped building radios and I became deeply involved in transmission, antenna and shortwave transmission. In short, I became involved, instead of listening to things, I became involved in transmitting things, building transmitters and building highly involved and complex amateur radio equipment that involved such things as Class B linear modulation and so on, all the way to this. You know, I don't want to start talking Greek to you, but it was a highly complex thing that I was involved in. Well, at about the age of 13, suddenly I looked around and I could see a world that was so complex, so infinitely exciting, so tremendously enticing, that there's no other way to say it except to say that probably the only thing that comes near to that is one of the basic human drives that is spelled with three simple letters. Isn't that true, Ed, when you get involved in a thing like this? I don't think women quite understand this. I have met very few women who are really that involved in the wild adventure of dealing with a combination of equipment, technique, abstraction, theory, and finally, let's say, total actuality. That to carry through this wildly involving and interesting thing where you built and designed a thing and created it and earned it and worked on it, got licensed to do it, and then one day was talking to somebody in Madrid with it. I mean, I can't express it. I really can't express it to you. It's like a guy probably writing his novel and it finally happens. Well, there were a lot of things, and I remember there was a teacher in high school. I don't know why I'm discussing this except to say that there's a great split between two sides of us. One side is the side that in a way can't even comprehend or deal with the daily problems. Like I would get tired thinking of just shoveling the ashes out. Whereas, if on the other hand, I was contemplating cutting a transformer hole for a Thordarson power transformer in a solid steel base that would take me 6 weeks hacking away with a chisel, cutting my hand off, going, and trying to drill it with ice picks, nothing would stop me. Absolutely nothing. So you know, it's a difficult thing to do. So I remember this finally came to a head. I have gotten myself licensed. Well, now, there was another license that went beyond the license, and that was what they used to call the Class A license. Now, the Class A license was like getting your PhD in the amateur radio world. And it was a very difficult exam at that time to pass. And it was an exam that sort of put a guy on a plane beyond, it's like, you know, becoming the general or something like that. And it involved one simple question. And I will tell you what the question was, which will not mean much to you. The question was, one question that they would ask all applicants for this, you had to diagram completely a complete transmitter, including antenna system, including values, including the modulation system, that means all the audio system that you have here, including, in some cases, they would even ask for waveforms at various points in the circuit. And you would have to, in short, draw a complete schematic diagram of a total transmitter, like WOR here, roughly, would be almost the equivalent of. Well, now that's quite an achievement for a 14-year-old kid, I can only say that. It is. So I didn't think of it as that way, though. It was like a pyramid. Maybe perhaps this is how I've come to have some knowledge of nuttiness that takes over. When you are driven by forces over which you have little or no control, it was like a whirlwind was going through my life, literally. And so I am working on this thing, and by now my family, it is as though my family is living with suddenly somehow a person who is speaking for some reason Sanskrit. And everybody else is talking Hammond, Indiana English, and they're like, get the hot dogs out, will you? And I'm down there trying to work on this Class B modulation system. And so I went up to the old post office building in Chicago to get my Class A exam. And I at this point, nobody knows in my family why I'm studying so hard. I'm already ham, you know, I'm already on the air. What is this, all this stuff? And I kept saying, Class A, Class A. and they didn't know. Well, I went up to take the examination, and they gave me the sealed envelope, and I opened it up, and I'm this little 14-year-old squirt, you know, and I open the thing up, and there it is. The first question says, please diagram with circuit values and with waveforms on the final plate. Waveforms on the final plate, also waveforms on the driver grid stages. Diagram completely a push-pull RF transmitter utilizing a doubler buffer, tri-tet oscillator, class B linear modulation with all driver stages. And also an 866 dual half-wave rectifier power supply. Well, okay, so I sat down there and I worked, and they give you a big sheet of paper, and I'm working this thing out. You know, beautiful lines. Yeah, I lay this thing out. It's just like a work of art, you know. And boy, when I would draw a triode, push-pull triode stage, you know, oh, man, it was like a work, like Jackson Pollock, you know, just everything beautiful down there. A coil just laid in there, and a transformer just stood there and shimmered. You could almost feel the reluctance in that thing. So I draw this thing all up. Then the next question, a question about auto relay stuff, and a lot of questions about modulation, and I'm breezing through this thing. And it's funny for a kid at the age of 14 to feel at the very absolute peak of his power. You know what I mean? Really on top of it, Dad. And on top, these guys could have really, anything they could have asked me, I could have handled. I could have got it. And so I just whip through this thing, and I go through the Class A examination in probably, maybe an hour. And I'm feeling gigantic, 14 feet tall. Well, I finish the Class A examination, and I come home, and I'm feeling fantastic. And it's a gigantic achievement, because here on all sides of me are grown men. Gray, bearded elders are sweating and throwing their pencils down. Hey, sir, come over here. And the RI keeps coming over here, and they're trying to get out of a question. Now, look, I don't understand. What do you mean? What is this? I can't. What's the wording of this question? Old Shep is just sitting there. let's see. Yeah, please. Yes, cathode follower circuit diagram. Of course, cathode follower. And I'm whipping away through this thing. Well, I get on. I have a budget. My yearly budget was roughly $7.25 for my entire yearly budget in those days. So I am riding the streetcar all the way back home, which is a 1,000-mile streetcar ride. It's like taking a streetcar roughly from here to Boston. So, it's that kind of streetcar. So I keep transferring streetcars, and I am looking at the rest of the people in the streetcar, these poor clods, these poor, simple toilers in the field. You know, here I am, Class A ham, W9QWN, W9QWN, Class A, 20-meter phone, the whole bit. So I'm in the elite, really, I knew it. I was like suddenly elevated to the peerage, and nobody knew it. So I'm sitting there looking around at all these people, and I'm beginning to feel more and more, because of the terrible thing that licenses do to people, it makes them feel superior. It really does. It makes you feel like somehow you really, you're different from other people. That's what also sheepskins do to people. Give them that little thing. Look out. Well, I'm riding the streetcar. I finally get off the streetcar, and I'm trudging on my way home. And I get home and walk in the house, and my mother says, "Well, how'd you do? You've been gone all day." I said, "Very good, very good." Of course, they don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just swaggering around. I get out 40 meters that night. Of course, I know that it's just a matter of time. It's going to come, Class A ticket. I'm on 40 CW, and my fist even improved. Ed, I'm telling you, I'm going 45. My bug was red hot that night. Boy, no standing waves tonight. Well, the next...